Sarah Jacobson, Marketing Artfully. Today I want to talk about priority mail. When I started selling on eBay a few years ago, my friend walked me through this and it made such a difference to me. And so I thought it would be fun if I walked you through it too. I use it for both eBay and Etsy, so it doesn't matter. But we're going to start with our priority mails. And I'll be doing a bunch of videos about different kinds of shipping. But this is priority mail using the USPS free items. So we're going to start with the flat rate padded envelope, which shows that USPS loves us, because anything that you can fit in there will ship for the base rate of, and I think it is the priority mail padded envelope is $7.10. So if you have something that's heavy as a brick, you can absolutely ship it for $7.10 as long as it fits in there. All they care about is that it'll close over it. Now, there's a bunch of different things that you can do with that. You can just shove it in there, get it shoved in. I use little boxes, especially when I'm shipping something that's fragile, but I still want to send it in a priority mail. And if it's going far across the country, it's a really good idea to use that padded mailer for the price. All right, second thing is going to be priority mail flat rate boxes. So this is a small priority rate flat box. There are three different sizes of priority mail flat boxes, small, which ships for $6.55. And I'll have the link to this priority mail page for you. Small flat rate boxes, $7.05, medium flat rate, $12.85, and a large flat rate anywhere across the country, United States, so even Hawaii, even Alaska, and that is for $17.65. Now, this will mess you the heck up if you're selling game boards or something like this and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm going to put it in a large flat rate box, and you don't have it very far to ship. So I'll give you an example. I sold a game, one of my very first sales, and I had bought it for $5. I thought it was a great price, and then I got the sale and they lived in Washington, and then I had to pay $17 to ship, and I had it listed for like $25. So you do the math. I didn't make any money. I might have lost some money on that sale with all the fees and the final value fees. So that's okay, though. You could use a regular box. You don't have to use that Bits It Ships, because they have a lot of different, like they have a lot of different things. Now, everywhere, I should have mentioned this before, every one of these boxes we're talking about, you can order from the post office for free, save your costs. Now, so those are our flat rate boxes. They also have a all different size boxes that are not If It Fits It Ships. So my favorite kind is the 7x7x6, and my husband mocks me. He just walked by and said the cat wants a 7x7x6. But they have 7x7x6s, they have large sizes, they have shoebox sizes, and then that's just going to be based on how far you have to ship and the weight of the item and the dimensions of the box, right? So those are excellent to use. And then the last thing we're going to talk about, and this is the most confusing, and those guys are over here. These guys are over here. This is the description of how to do regional boxes, which is not all that descriptive, if you ask me. So what regional boxes are, oh, and my mail lady's here. I'm going to pause for 1 minute. Crisis averted. Okay. So our last one is regional A and regional B. And these are for heavy items. Usually if you have something that's light, you're not going to get anything, and you could even pay extra. So make sure to check. But if you are shipping something, and the regions that they talk about are, I live in Florida, the next region is Georgia, the next region might be South Carolina, New York might be 6 or 7 regions from me, Washington might be a ton of regions from me. So what happens is, I've done this before, if I have something to ship within the state of Florida, I check my regional and see if I could find a box that will fit it, because they have some big boxes. So this is a really nice size box. You can fit quite a bit into that, and they also have like the long skinny ones, And so if you're shipping close regionally, you want to try the regional A's and B's. Now, the regional A is much smaller. I have shipped things, what I've done is I've shipped things that are super, super heavy. Like I ship doorstops that are iron and old and weigh a ton. So You can do that. And then the regional B boxes are going to cost a little bit more in shipping, but they go a little bit further. And then they discontinued. So if anybody tells you about the amazing regional C, they used to have big boxes that were regional, and they discontinued those. So unfortunately, that's out for now. So hopefully that helps. Tara Jacobson, marketing artfully.